Today I want to talk about a tool called SSHuttle. SSHuttle is a Python program that lets you create transparent proxy, and you can use that transparent proxy as your free SSH VPN tunnel. SSHuttle can be installed using Package Manager like apt on Ubuntu or Homebrew on macOS, but because it's Python program, it can also be installed using pip install command. Doesn't really matter, because today I will show you step by step how to configure it from scratch and how it works. But let's start from the beginning. Why would you even want a VPN? And there are multiple reasons why you might want a VPN. Maybe you have a laptop or a PC at home and you don't want your service provider to look into your traffic. You don't want them to know what and when you're accessing. So you can encrypt all the traffic that is coming out of your device, send it to some remote server, and that server will forward it further to the internet. And then on the way back, it will tunnel it back to your home. The service provider will only see the SSH tunnel between you and the remote server, but they will have no idea what is inside it and what you are trying to access. But the same tunnel can be used for a very different scenario. Maybe you are traveling to other countries, but you still want to access all your home network devices. And you can use SSHuttle to do that as well. What you have to do before your journey though, you need to set up a port forwarding on your router for port 22, and that's it. You can then install and configure SSHuttle on your laptop, and you will be able to access your entire home network as if you were physically there. And you just need one port forwarding rule on your home router. In hacking terms, this is called network pivoting. So you say that you pivot through a network to access other devices in that network. But we are not going to hack anything, we would use SSHuttle as our free VPN connection back to our home, in our scenario. But just think what you can do next. Once you have that tunnel back to your home or any other remote server back in your country, now you can access all your streaming services, which usually have some regional restrictions. You wouldn't be able to access them directly when you are abroad. And the SSHuttle can do even much more than that. Let's say, what if you got a laptop from your work and that laptop already has a VPN configured on it? And it's very often the case because your company wants your connection to be secure when you are accessing their internal network. That makes sense. But the SSHuttle works very fancy way, and it can actually build SSH tunnel on top of that already VPN encrypted traffic, which means you can have a VPN tunnel inside SSHuttle tunnel, or that SSH tunnel that is created. And SSHuttle can redirect that entire already encrypted connection, it can redirect it back to your home or whatever server you want first, and then it will be securely delivered there to that remote server. Then that outer SSH tunnel will be stripped off and the inside traffic will be forwarded further with only that one remaining work VPN tunnel configured. But that means you can travel to any country you want, but your connection will be seen as coming constantly from the same location. But okay, that's enough of the theory. Let's see how we configure that thing. And I will create a free server in AWS cloud. So I'm not connecting back to home, I'm connecting to some remote server. And in AWS cloud, you can configure a server that will be free of charge for entire year. And there are also some other cloud providers, I believe Oracle has a server that you can create and it's free for life. I'm not sure if that offering is still valid, but you have to have a look. But there are many ways that will let you run server for free. So let's use that AWS. If you don't have an AWS account, I've got a video on how to create one. And I am in region North California. That's where I am going to build my server. But I am personally in UK. I live in UK, so California is very distant from me. But for our video, let's say I live maybe in California and I'm traveling to UK. Doesn't really matter. Let's just launch instance. It means create a virtual server. And I will call it, I don't know, SSHuttle. I will scroll down, I will choose Ubuntu. Ubuntu is free tier eligible. And then I will scroll further, T2 Micro also says free tier eligible. And what that means, it says on the right, free tier. You can run that server for 750 hours every month, and it will like auto-renew for the following month, and you can run it for a year, not paying anything, if you do not exceed that 750 hours. And that's awesome. I will scroll further. Keeper is a SSH keeper, and I already uploaded my public SSH key, so I can pick it here. This is public key from my laptop that I have in UK. Then go further to network settings, and I just have to make sure I will have public IP address, and it is enabled option, And then the rule to allow SSH traffic is already automatically created for me anyway, so I don't have to change anything here. And then the storage, it's just 8 gig, but you know what? It's enough. We are not going to store anything there. We are just going to go through that server to access anything else. That's it really. Let's just launch instance. Took just a few seconds. I've got my instance up and running. This is my public IP address, and I should be able to access it from this laptop. So let's open terminal. I should be able to SSH as a user Ubuntu, that's the default one, at that IP address. I just have to confirm, yes. And that's it. I am on that remote server. If I run curl ifconfigme command, we can see the public IP of that server. And if I run curl ipinfo.io, I can see this server is in San Jose, in California. So now let me exit it. That's really all I need. I don't have to configure anything else. I just need SSH connection from my laptop to that remote server. Now I'm back on my laptop. So just to confirm, if I do the same commands again, like curl ipinfo.io, now you can see I'm indeed in England, in Great Britain, and I've got different IP address. Hope that all makes sense so far. Let me clear that. Maybe I will move it here. What I have to do on my laptop, I have to first install SSHuttle. It's not a tool that is by default here. And by the way, my laptop also runs on Ubuntu, as you can see. I mean, it's a macOS, but Ubuntu runs in parallels. Never mind. So I run command sudo apt install SSHuttle. And now that's the thing. You have to be either root or you have to have sudo privileges on the client machine, on this local laptop. But you don't have to have root permissions on the remote server. That Ubuntu user is fine. But here on the client machine, I need to have sudo privileges. So let me type in the password. We will confirm, yes. And that's it. Let's clear it again. Now I just forgot to mention one thing. You have to have, on both client and remote server, you have to have Python installed, because SSHuttle is Python application. But because Ubuntu already has Python installed, I don't have to worry about that. But if you use other distribution or other system, you might need to install Python first, so bear that in mind. But anyways, what I can do now is run command SSHuttle, then dash R. That means I want to connect to a remote server. And now what is that remote server? Well, it was user Ubuntu at that public IP address. So the user and IP is exactly as what we used for SSH connectivity. And now what I want to do next, let me type it in first. These all zeros, 0.0.0.0/0, that means that I want to tunnel all the traffic. That 0.0.0 says that you simply want to tunnel everything. You want to tunnel all traffic coming out of this device. And by the way, that notation can be shortened to just 0/0. This is basically the same. 0/0 is the same as the previous one. But what I wanted to say here, maybe you just want to tunnel a portion of the traffic. Maybe you are connecting to your home and your home subnet is maybe 10.1.2.0 and it's /24. That would mean I only want to go through the tunnel when I'm trying to reach this network. And we can go even further. I can use it to only reach one IP address on one specific port. Maybe I've got a server there that runs on port 80 and I want to access only that. That means only traffic to that destination will be going over the tunnel and everything else will just go directly to the internet with no tunnel. But for the time being, I just want to tunnel everything that is sent out of this machine. So let's just stick to that 0/0. So that means what I want to include. But last but not least, you can use -x to exclude some IP addresses or subnets. And you want to exclude the public IP you are connecting to. I mean this one. You have to exclude the remote server's public IP address. Let me do that. You have to do that, otherwise SSHuttle will try to tunnel the tunnel that it's trying to create. And it's not a problem specific to SSH tunneling. If you ever configured like IPsec or GRE or any other tunnels, you probably came across that scenario. And you know that you need to exclude that remote IP address to prevent it from tunneling itself. I believe I didn't have to do it on Mac, it somehow worked without that X, but now I run it on Linux instances, and all of them need that parameter added to work correctly. So, to be on the safe side, always do that exclusion, regardless what system you are setting it up. Alright, let's just press enter now. And it tells me I'm connected to a server. So what I can do now, let me open another session. I am on my laptop, and I will run curl ipinfo.io. I am still on my laptop, but it shows me that I am in San Jose in California. Which is not true, because I'm in England. But from wherever that ipinfo.io is running, server, for that server it looks like I am sitting in San Jose in California. My traffic is tunneled from England to US, to California. The outer SSH tunnel is stripped off, and then it's forwarded further to the internet. And the internet believes that I'm in San Jose. Okay, I hope that makes sense. Now, I just wanted to show you how to stop SSHuttle, because you can try to control C. You can see it not always works. So what I have to do, I have to find the PID, process ID, of that program. So in this new session, I will use pgrep shuttle command. And this is the process ID. So I can use now kill -15180 the process ID. Now it's killed. As you can see, terminated. And I'm back to my command line. If now I run the command again, curl ipinfo, I am back in England, GB. And by the way, it's possible to create a service file for SSHuttle, and then you can run commands like systemctl start SSHuttle, or stop SSHuttle, or restart SSHuttle, which is a bit more graceful than just killing PID. But that is outside of the scope of today's video, as I wanted to keep it short and simple. And I just wanted to show you one more thing. I just typed man sshuttle. This is simply the manual for that sshuttle utility. And you can see here, sshuttle allows you to create a VPN connection. We already know that, and that's pretty cool. But you can also run it on the router. There are routers, like Linux-based, and you can forward entire traffic for entire subnet to the VPN. That means all your devices you have at home will use that SSH tunnel. And then subnets, we already talked about that. You can forward, you can tunnel the traffic if the destination is specific IP address and specific port. And if you go further, you can see loads of options, but the one that you might be interested in is that --DNS, which forwards the DNS requests, forwards them to the remote DNS server. Because I used only IP addresses, but maybe you have host names, so that's most probably the option you want to add to your command. Just have a look, just read through it, and you will see how much more you can do with that tool. And the last thing, I already opened a new tab, but I wanted to do it previously, but let's just Google sshuttle. And that will give you the GitHub page. And if we scroll down to the very bottom, you will find further documentation and instructions like how to run it as a service, etc. Which is very useful as well. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope it makes sense, and thank you for watching.